Hey, Mark, I can't fix this, I can't patch it.
Yeah.
It's a major drama and I don't want to run it.
Just weeks into the mining season, Mark's 45-tonne excavator, vital for penetrating opal-bearing rock, has suffered a catastrophic failure.
She's leaking out bottom of the pump there.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, you can see that the pulley itself's out of line, so the bearing must have...
Yeah, bearing's gone. It's gone.
A water pump circulates coolant through the excavator's engine block and radiator, preventing the machine from overheating.
So how long's that going to take, mate, to get to Woomera then? A couple of days.
As Mark attempts to source a water pump, the only chance of finding opal lies with Oscar, operating their 2.5-tonne digger, and Luca, spotting at the mine wall.
She's pretty new to it. Hopefully she's across it when it comes to spotting me, because the last thing we want is to smash any opal or, yeah, sort of dig in places that, you know, we don't want to. Find something, sis?
Yeah, there's been a trace here.
What do we got? Oh, still just pots, little bits of, like, purple and stuff, but no money yet.
Potch is opal with no play of colour and of little value.
That's just potch. I just want to see some opal.
The following day, rain brings a new threat from opal thieves known as ratters.
With the dirt sitting here in the pit, a bit of rain just washes all the dust off the top and, you know, leaves it sitting exposed like that piece there. So, you know, if you've got colour bars through that, anyone can pretty much come in helping themselves. So, you know, you just hate to think someone else is coming through here just picking up, you know, your money.
This is a telltale sign of what ratters do. They'll use little jackhammers and they'll dig out little pockets like this.
Recreational opal hunters known as fossickers take advantage of heavy rain, which exposes opal, allowing them to spot the gem on public land. But it's illegal for them to trespass on registered claims.
This is our livelihood, and, you know, if they pick out a lot of it, well, that, you know, it's a big financial burden to us, that's for sure.
The opal-bearing dirt Mark and Chris have already mined from the open cut lies in exposed stockpiles. Without the excavator, they can't load the truck and get the dirt to their agitator wash plant for processing.
Feels like someone's here. Yeah, she's here. Woo! Hello, my darling. My lovely wife, Fiona. Good news is she's bringing the part that we need for the excavator.
So hopefully this is the fix.
You're a legend.
God bless her. She's doing a 10-hour drive down to bring the part straight to us, or else we would have had to wait at least a week for that to get shipped down.
It went together pretty good, so fingers crossed.
Let's fire the big girl up.
Righto.
Ready-o.
I'll just put a little scoop on top there, mate.
She should be good.
Righto, brother. Pretty happy to get this dirt out of this hole. We've been seeing some beautiful colour, and we'll get it out of here and into the agitator. Kind of like money in the bank.
Yeah, I'm just glad we could bloody have a tail out.
Yeah, mate, finally got her in. Bit of messing around, wasn't it?
The Cheals have just washed a truckload of dirt from their open-cut mine in their agitator for 12 hours, a process that separates the dirt from rock to expose any opal.
We put one truckload in, so about 20 tonne.
Mark's wife Fiona is joining the team for the tail out as an extra pair of hands and eyes.
Holy s***!
Oh, wow!
Imagine
his
dad. That just rolled out.
Hold on, Luca.
Oh, f***, mate!
We got one.
Oh, look at that. Woo! That's what we're looking for, guys. What?
No way. No way! Look at the bars in it.
Oh, my God.
We've hit a massive pocket, and it just brought it on. It was unbelievable.
Oh, it's just like, boom, there's a 10 carat frame, there's a 15 carat frame, there's a 20 carat frame.
Oi! Oi! We got red on black!
Wow!
Red on black!
Oh, God!
Oh, look at that, Jim!
Look at that! You're
kidding me.
Runner! Oh.
Oh, far out.
We had a lot of money here because there's a few pieces there that are just gem, red on black.
Yeah.
And that's your money maker, you know?
Yeah.
What a word, Joe. Like, look at this one. Like, look at that.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, that one.
That's insane. 40 to 50 to possibly 80 to 100 grand stones in here.
Singular stones.
That's exactly right.
But that's the gem bucket, that's the colour bucket.
There's going to be 5 and 10,000 all the stones in there.
That's our colour bucket.
So every piece in there is hit with some form of colour.
Maybe I've underestimated it a bit.
The Cheals have high-end crystal and seam opal, featuring the most valuable combination, rare red on a black base. It's in the rough, and there's 2 kilograms.
There's a gem green bar in there. Look at that.
Yeah.
I would say conservatively, you know, you're looking at 400 to 500 grand. That's honestly what I reckon.
It's the best. It have to be.
We're halfway to our season target and we're only just started. I don't want to be overconfident, but geez, if it keeps coming like this, that $1 million, we're gonna eat that up and spit it out the other side.
$450,000 is the Cheals' biggest ever find.
Table length full of gems isn't bad, eh?
Hard to put into words just what happened, really. Like, it's a minor stream. Oh, we've just come across a huge pocket and literally dollar signs come down that chute. Yeah.
It's the kind of game where you find that much, you're like, okay, let's find the next big thing. Like, Dad will be like, okay, what else is out there? Like, let's get into it.
We had an absolute cracker of a tie-up. One of the best I've ever seen. Just... Still can't, but I was still pinching myself how good that tail out was. It was just a massive, massive amount of opal.
I couldn't have asked for a better start as far as opal production. It's just been amazing. And we know we're near up to the production levels I want to take us to, so it's going to be unbelievable.